Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4 through 5. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. Amen.
Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4 to 5. Amen.
Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4 through 5. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. Amen.
Everyone, I got a love and it's deep down in my heart. I want you to repeat with me. It's deep.
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 All together.
Deep down in my heart.
That love and it's deep down in our hearts. Everyone, I want you to stand up. I want you to move your bodies and I want you to shout for joy.
Deep down.
나를 향하신 하나님의 계획을 믿어요.
Trust in God's plans for me.
그런즉 나를 이리로 보낸 이는 당신들이 아니오 하나님이시라. 하나님이 나를 바로에게 아버지로 삼으시고 그 온 집에 주로 삼으시며 애굽 온 땅의 통치자로 삼으셨나이다. 창세기 45장 8절 말씀.
So then, it was not you who sent me here, but God. He made me father of Pharaoh, lord of his entire household and ruler of all Egypt. Genesis 45 verse 8.
하나님이 주신 지혜로 바로 왕이 꾼 꿈의 뜻을 말해준 요셉은 애굽의 가장 높은 신하인 총리가 되었어요. 그리고 왕의 꿈처럼 애굽에 풍년이 들었어요. 애굽의 곡식과 과일이 많이 열리자 요셉은 곡식을 많이 거두어서 창고에 쌓아두었어요. 쌓아둔 곡식은 너무 많아서 다 셀 수가 없을 정도였어요.
With God-given wisdom, Joseph was able to interpret King Pharaoh's dream and became the highest leader of the country. Then, just like the King Pharaoh's dream, the harvest was plentiful and Joseph started to store many crops into the storage. It was so much that he could not store all of it in the storage.
7년 동안의 풍년이 다 끝나고 난 후에는 요셉이 말한 것대로 7년 동안 가뭄이 시작됐어요. 사람들은 먹을 것이 없었어요. 하지만 곡식을 많이 모아두었던 애굽에는 먹을 것이 있었어요.
There were 7 years full of crops to harvest. And just like what Joseph had said, the 7 years of famine has started. Famine means there was no crop growing and nothing to eat from. People did not have food to eat. However, there were food to eat in Egypt because Joseph has stored the food in the storage.
시간이 지나 온 땅에 심한 가뭄이 들었어요. 요셉의 고향 가나안 땅에도 곡식이 모자랐어요. 아버지 야곱은 애굽에는 미리 모아둔 곡식이 있다는 이야기를 듣고 요셉의 10명의 형들을 불렀어요.
가뭄이 들어서 이제 우리 집도 먹을 것이 다 떨어져 가는구나. 그런데 너희들은 이렇게 가만히 앉아있기만 하면 어떻게 하느냐? 저기 애굽에는 곡식이 있다고 하던데 너희들이 애굽으로 내려가서 우리가 먹을 곡식 좀 사오너라. 그래야 먹고 살 수 있지는 않겠느냐?
Time has passed and extreme famine has started. Even in the city of Canaan, where Joseph was from, they did not have any food to eat. Joseph's father Jacob heard that there were food that was stored in the storage, so he called all his 11 sons.
We are running out of food now, but how can you guys just only stay still? I heard that there are some crops in Egypt. You guys go to the Egypt and buy some crops from them.
아버지의 말을 들은 10명의 형들은 곡식을 사기 위해 애굽으로 내려갔어요. 친구들, 애굽의 총리가 누구죠?
맞아요, 바로 동생 요셉이에요.
그런데 형들은 요셉이 애굽의 총리가 되었을 줄은 꿈에도 생각은 못했을 거예요. 형들은 아마 자기들이 팔아버린 요셉이 종이나 거지가 되었거나 아님 이미 죽었을 거라고 생각했을 것 같아요. 총리가 된 요셉은 애굽에 곡식을 사러 온 사람들에게 곡식을 팔고 있었어요.
After the father Jacob had spoken to the sons, they all went to Egypt to buy some food to eat. Do you guys remember who the highest leader of Egypt was? Yes, it was Joseph. I bet the brothers did not have a clue about how Joseph became a leader of Egypt. Not even in their dreams. That their brothers that they sold as slaves became the highest and the greatest leader of Egypt. I bet they thought that he was already dead or became a servant of somebody. At that time, Joseph was selling and giving out the crops to the Egypt people.
Joseph의 형들이 곡식을 살 차례가 되었어요. 요셉은 곡식을 사러 온 형들을 보자마자 한 번에 알아봤어요. 하지만 형들은 요셉을 전혀 알아보지 못했어요. 형들은 총리 요셉 앞에 엎드려 절을 하며 말을 했어요. 총리님, 저희는 가나안에서 먹을 것이 없어 곡식을 사러 왔습니다.
어? 이 장면 어디서 본 적 없나요?
Finally, it became Joseph's brother's turn to buy some crops from Joseph, the highest leader of Egypt. Then Joseph saw the brothers, and he instantly recognized them in his first sight. But brothers did not recognize Joseph. The brothers bowed down to Joseph, the leader, and said to him, "My master, we are here from Canaan because we do not have any food to eat."
Wait a minute. Do you guys remember this scene from before?
요셉이 어릴 때 꾼 꿈 생각나지 않아요? 요셉도 자신에게 절을 하는 형들을 보자 어릴 때 꾸었던 꿈이 생각났어요. 형님들의 곡식단이 요셉의 곡식단에 절을 하던 꿈, 그리고 해와 달과 11별이 요셉에게 절을 하던 꿈 말이에요.
Do you remember when Joseph had a dream when he was very young? Joseph remembered that he had a dream that his brothers were bowing down to him. The dream where his brothers' crops were bowing down to Joseph's crops. Then the dream when the moon, the sun, and 11 stars were bowing to him.
와, 정말로 요셉을 향한 하나님의 계획이 드디어 이루어졌네요. 비록 요셉은 형들의 미움을 받아 애굽으로 팔려가 종이 되었고 또 억울하게 감옥에도 갇혔지만 하나님께서는 요셉을 향한 계획을 잊지 않으셨어요. 하나님이 주신 꿈처럼 요셉을 애굽의 총리로 세워주셨잖아요.
It really happened as God has planned. Although Joseph was sent to Egypt because his brothers hated him, and although he was sold as a slave, and although he was sent to jail for an unfair reason, God was still with him and he did not forget about Joseph. Just like the God-given dream, God made Joseph the highest leader of Egypt.
요셉은 울면서 형님들에게 말했어요. 형님들, 제가 바로 형들의 동생 요셉입니다. 형님들이 애굽의 노예로 팔았던 그 요셉이란 말이에요. 그 말을 들은 형들은 깜짝 놀랐어요. 그리고 무섭기도 했어요. 왜냐하면 자신들이 요셉을 노예로 팔았기 때문에 복수를 당할까봐 두려웠어요.
Joseph was in tears and said to his brothers, "Hey, it's me, Joseph. I'm your brother. I am Joseph, who you have sold to Egypt as slave." When his brothers heard that, they were so shocked and scared at the same time. They were scared because they thought that Joseph might give back revenge on them.
친구들이 만약에 요셉이었다면 어떻게 했을 것 같아요? 만약 요셉이라면 형들에게 크게 화를 내고 나처럼 똑같이 당해봐라. 노예도 되어보고 감옥에도 갇혀보고 내가 너희들에게 너희 때문에 얼마나 힘들게 살았는지 알게 해주고 싶었을 것 같아요.
What would you do if you were in Joseph's shoes? It's so normal to want to be angry at them and hope that they have the same thing back at them and say, "I hope you go through the same thing as me. I hope you become a slave and go into the jail."
하지만 요셉은 달랐어요. 요셉은 형들을 용서했어요. 형님들 걱정하거나 미안해하지 마세요. 제가 애굽으로 온 것은 바로 하나님께서 하신 일이에요. 하나님께서 저를 형님들보다 먼저 이곳 애굽으로 보내신 것은 많은 사람들의 생명을 구하게 하시고 우리 가족들도 살아남게 하시기 위해서였으니까요. 그리고 요셉은 형들에게 아버지 야곱과 동생 베냐민도 모두 애굽으로 데리고 와서 함께 살자고 이야기했어요.
However, Joseph was different. Joseph forgave his brothers and said, "Hey brothers, don't be worried or be sorry. The reason why I was sent to Egypt as a slave was God's plan for me. God wanted me to be here before you to save more people's lives and also to save our family as well." Then Joseph invited all of his family, including his father, to live with him in Egypt.
요셉이 살아있다는 소식을 들은 아버지는 온 가족을 이끌고 가나안 땅에서 애굽으로 이사를 왔어요. 이때 애굽으로 함께 간 가족들은 모두 70명이었어요. 그리고 온 가족이 다시 만나게 되었어요. 그리고 요셉 덕분에 모든 가족들은 심한 가뭄에서도 먹을 것을 걱정하지 않고 잘 지낼 수 있었어요.
When Father Jacob heard about Joseph, he took all his family and moved to Egypt. The total number of family was 70 in total. Finally, all the family met together again. And the whole family was able to eat and not worry about famine because of Joseph.
요셉을 통해서 많은 사람들을 살리는 것이 바로 하나님의 계획이었어요. 요셉은 많은 어려움을 겪었지만 하나님께서 요셉을 먼저 애굽으로 보내셔서 총리가 되게 하셨기 때문에 온 가족들이 먹을 것이 없이 죽지 않고 살 수 있었어요. 선하신 하나님의 계획이 요셉을 통해 이루어진 거예요.
The plan to save many people's lives through Joseph was all God's plan. Joseph went through a lot, but God sent Joseph to Egypt in advance to become a great leader of Egypt to save more people.
하나님께서는 우리 친구들 한 사람 한 사람을 향한 하나님의 계획을 갖고 계세요. 비록 그 가정 속에서 어려움을 당할 수도 있고 그 꿈이 불가능 것처럼 보일 때도 있을 거예요. 하지만 하나님께서는 반드시 하나님의 계획을 선하게 이루어 주셔요. 요셉처럼 나를 향한 하나님의 계획을 믿고 살아가는 친구들이 되길 바래요.
God has plans for every one of you guys very specifically. We may face difficulties and struggles in the progress. And the dreams that God gave may even seem impossible. But God's plan for you will become true in your life and He will make it pure and holy. I hope that you guys have faith and trust in God's plan for your life as well.
Let's all pray. Father, I thank you so much for being our God who's so faithful to us in our lives. Just like how you were so faithful to Joseph's lives, help us to really trust and believe that your plans in our life is holy and that is what you want for us. And I pray that even in the midst of struggles and hurdles and difficulties, help us to have faith in you, believing that you have us in your hands and you're walking with us every step of the way. I ask that you may be with us throughout the week. Help us to get to know you more, become more like you. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
The memory verse comes from the book of Luke, chapter 19, verse 10. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost.
This week's challenge is to read the scripture once a day. I am going to ask you guys to read anywhere in the Bible. You can pick any book, any chapter, but it has to be once a day. And as far as the video, I want y'all to record about what you guys have read throughout the week. I'm excited and looking forward to hear all the stories.
Let us all recite the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
아 워십 유